Hi. So, okay, today I'm going to do days 29 and 30. And I'm not going to do anything tomorrow because we're going to be busy packing to go to the Baltic. And you're not going to hear from me for about a week. Yeah, I think so. 7, 8 days. Today we have been doing some last minute shopping for things we need. And because I got to leave the house, I dressed up. I wore jewelry and everything. So, yeah. Let me go ahead and get this out of the way. And then I have a buttload more stuff that needs doing. So, okay. Day 29, handheld foods. It starts innocently enough. You reach for a few potato chips or a handful of nuts. Maybe you open a bag of M&Ms, and as soon as the first handful is gone, you reach for another one. The next thing you know, you get caught in a hand-to-mouth pattern that's almost impossible to stop. Think about all the foods that come in bite-sized servings or ones that you eat from your hand. To be able to enjoy your handheld snacks without getting addicted to them, you need to set up strategies that will keep these foods in the bowl instead of your hand. Start by putting a buffer between any bite-sized foods and your mouth. One trick is to eat small-sized foods with a utensil. For example, try eating M&Ms with a fork. Slide nuts onto a spoon before tossing them into your mouth. Pour a stack of tortilla chips or other small snacks onto a plate and then cut them into pieces before you nibble them. You probably eat less because the reward doesn't seem worth the effort it takes to put the food into a spoon. Today's assignments. 1. Select a handheld food item such as nuts, chips, or candy pieces. Measure out a precise serving such as 1/4 cup or 2 tablespoons and then put this amount on a plate. Write down the food you're using for this exercise. 2. Sit down at a table with the food in front of you. Use a fork or a spoon. Eat one piece at a time. Notice how it feels to eat your snack this way. Describe it. 3. Write down a few notes for how you will manage handheld foods in the future. So, I am not doing today's homework because I don't generally eat handheld foods. And I'm not going to go get some to do the homework. I very rarely will have some of my husband's nuts or trail mix or something. But that's very rare. And I put it in a little bowl, measured out. And when I'm done, that's it. So, I don't eat chips. Anymore. But they just don't fit in my diet. They don't fit in my life. Yeah, M&Ms. So sorry, no. However, if you are someone who eats chips, M&Ms, or trail mix or whatever on a regular basis, this might be good to try. I don't know. Could help you. It does not apply to me. Day 30. Postpone eating. We've all heard the taunting advertising line, "You can't eat just one." Of course, we also know how true this can be. To prevent hand-to-mouth problems with snack foods, decide that you will postpone eating them. Tell yourself you can have some of the food, but that you'll wait a while before taking the first taste. Sometimes you'll wait 10 minutes, other times you might hold off for a couple of hours. When you go to a card party, baby shower, or other social gathering, postpone reaching for food and don't eat anything until the very end of the event. When it's almost time to go home, decide if you still want some of the snacks. If you do, go ahead and eat them. But by not eating until the last 10 minutes of the gathering, you'll do a lot less damage than if you'd nibbled all evening. Today's assignment. 1. Watch for places where you can postpone eating. Hold off as long as possible, especially with snack foods or sweets. Make a list of times or places where you can use this concept. 2. Record each of the foods you postponed and then note how much you ate compared to your usual amount. 3. Notice whether by postponing eating you are able to skip some foods entirely. Write notes about how you're planning to use this concept. Okay. I don't go anywhere. I don't even know when I could use this. I very rarely go anywhere, and even when I do, it's not the kind of places where you get snack food. And I think if I tried, to postpone eating, like back when we went to Yen's friend Daniel's birthday party, and his mother was very much, "Eat, eat, eat. Why are you not eating?" And because I had to wait with the baby and things and the yeah, I think she felt it was rather rude. So I don't even know. I frankly, I don't know what to do this one. I don't have anywhere to use it at. Too bad, so sad. So those two, if you can use them, yeah, great. I'm sure they work. If you're like me and you have no use for them because this is not something you do, skip it. Alrighty. So, yeah. And Liz is asleep now. So I have no one to badger me. However, when I find the time today to actually do my exercise, I'm going to do it. Despite the fact that I've been on my feet all day long, running here and there, pushing the stroller, you know. It's okay. Dog, come here. Come here. Y'all get to see the puppy. Let me see if I can get this big mutt's head in the frame. Come here. Come here. Come here. Come here. Big monster. Come here. Come here. Sit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, he just laid down. Y'all don't get to see him. He's a big old mutt. A big old mutt. Alrighty. So, yeah. Hope everybody has a great day, and I've got stuff to do. So, bye. Oh. Almost forgot. My very first troll came visiting my profile. I deleted their comment, but I cracked up laughing. It was ridiculous. Quit sleeping with people so you won't be fat. And I'm like, what? I don't even. Bunch of nutters. Cracked me up. So, yeah. bye. Have a great day, everybody.